Every year we have Vincentian family in Indonesia conduct during the month of May, conduct the preparation for taking perpetual vows for the congregation belongs to the Vincentian family. This formation, you may say, is one of the kind of our collaboration as Vincentian family. We also conduct formation for those religious who are in the old age already. And in the mid-year of age, but this formation, especially for those who are going to take perpetual vows, are the one with conduct regularly every May of the year since 10 years ago actually, the 2009. During this formation, we would like to emphasize the characteristic, the Vincentian characteristic of our identity as a Vincentian congregation. What are the program consists of? We will hear from Sister Josephine KEM, which since in the beginning together we collaborate in form the Vincentian religious in taking perpetual vows.
In order to get acquainted with the Vincentian spirituality, in this program, we study, we recognize again what is the characteristic of Vincentian family. The characteristic of Vincentian family is charity. Charity for those who need, especially for the poor. We take time to think about the life of Vincent de Paul. We take time to study about him and also to get connected with him by recognizing our own personal experience. In this way, we hope that we help the young people, this young sister or brother, who recognize their vocation. The calling itself for the Vincent de Paul is developed within himself. As Vincent developed within himself that calling, we try also to do the same thing with this young sister or brother. Try to recognize within themselves that calling and develop it. Of course, the foundation of that is the characteristic of the gospel, to be charitable.
The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. Yeah. I am sent to preach the gospel to the poor. Luke chapter 4, verses 18.
Thank you, Father. So this gospel, we think about it, we reflect about it. So not only word outside ourselves, but become ours, become mine, because I recognize that in my personal experience. That is how we try to help these young people. We really believe this kind of charity, this really a big contribution for the church to continue the mission of the church for the people. So because of that, we would like to develop this to help the young people to undertake the task to continue that, because that is a contribution for the church, not only for the church but also for the society. We believe that is our calling. That's why we would like to continue this program every year to help the young people to cultivate within themselves that calling. Hopefully they recognize their own calling, they can develop it and they grow in it, and hopefully they are happy in that vocation.
Yeah. So usually we begin this course, this formation courses with the spirit of their own founder. No. How that founder taking part in the Vincentian spirituality. like some congregation, they focus for disabled people, the one founded by Father Jansen. The other congregation founded by PMJ and Tris, Father Tris, Brother of Charity, focus even for the deaf people, and now they are also focus on insane.
Yeah.
For the insane people, especially those who are abandoned insane people, and also those victim of narcotics. The last year, we Vincentian family also focus our work. Actually, it's not really the kind of work, but the foundation, the strategy, which we call systemic change. So we work not only giving the poor alms, but we ask the poor, collaborate with the poor to better their life systemically. We know that life actually is systemic. The systemic change theory actually go hand in hand with the organic organic plantation, which we go back to the nature, how the plantation can grow and fertilize by the natural fertilizer. And that's of course not only about that thing, but also the how they can market that their product to the people. By this kind of work, we try to contribute for the bettering of our society, of our world, especially also because we know that the economic now, the technology now, are not really friendly to the environment, to the environment. And because of that, there are many the destruction of the environment, and the primary victim of that is again the poor. We hope by this information there are already people also who are going to will to collaborate with us in any kind for the bettering of the society, for the bettering of the church. Thank you very much.